Hello students, in the last video we have seen how to create profit and loss, or how the main thing that we have seen is how we use the if function, right? So how we use the if function that we have seen in my last video. On this same Excel sheet we will see how to use the maximum function, average function, say minimum function and count function. Alright, so for that let's create a table here, cell. Okay, so say let's name it maximum profit. Okay, maximum profit, then I'll adjust search. Okay, so here let's say in maximum profit we can also find say profit that, or let's see, let's make this as average profit. All right, then let's make this as maximum profit. Then we can use, or we can see another use of, yes, so let's see, we'll see another use of if else or if statement by seeing which profit or which quarter has the maximum profit. Okay, so maximum profit quarter. Okay, so we'll find out which quarter has the maximum profit, right? So okay, so maximum profit quarter we can find out. All right, okay, so now let's see. So for average, so average you will write AVG formula. After that we will select whichever sales average we need. So we need profit and loss, so we'll select the amount, this comma, select the next cell that is quarter 2 amount, comma, next cell that is quarter 3 amount, comma, next cell that is quarter 4 amount. All right, so close it and we'll find the average. So we found an error. Okay, so there is some. Alright, so this will be the average E4. Okay, so let's check it once again. Amount E4, amount I4, then amount is M4, and amount is E4. Alright, so average you can say it is more of like loss. Okay, so in average, right, so maximum profit we can find how. So similarly we'll write here equal, for maximum we'll write max. Okay, then select the, so again amount, comma, amount of quarter 2, comma, amount of quarter 3, comma, amount of quarter 4. Alright, so let's close it and under. So maximum profit that we have earned is 2 lakh, that is in the quarter 1. Alright. So you can select and drag. Now, how we'll select in which quarter I have earned the maximum profit that we have to do. So for that equal if, alright, then we'll write the condition. So here condition will be, so condition will be, what will check, if the maximum profit is equal to, if the maximum profit is equal to amount of quarter 1, right, profit amount of quarter 1, then which quarter is the maximum profit? Obviously Q1, right? So I can directly print Q1. Now see nicely, okay? So I cannot now directly write quarter 2 here. If this condition is false, then I cannot write directly quarter 2. Why? Because there is quarter 2, then there is quarter 3 also, then is quarter 4 also. So possibilities, there are more possibilities than only quarter 2, okay? So again, what I have to do is inside if, again I have to write another if. Alright, so there again I will select profit, sorry, maximum profit. I will check if maximum profit is equal to amount of quarter 2, then print quarter 2. Alright, again what will happen if it is not true? Then again I have to check, because there is quarter 3 and quarter 4. If maximum profit is equal to amount of quarter 3, then if maximum profit is equal to amount of quarter 3, then which quarter has the most profit? Obviously quarter 3, Q3, or else here directly you can write Q4, because there is no other remaining quarters, right? This is the last option we have. So we'll close for first if, then second if, then the very beginning if that we have started. Enter. So see, quarter 1 is the maximum profit. Similarly for others, the maximum profit here is quarter 3, quarter 2, quarter 3, quarter 1. You can check it yourself, right? So if you minimize it, you can check. No. So now you can see tires. This is the, so here quarter 3 is the maximum profit. Let's see. So amount of quarter 3 profit is 2,12,584. Amount, so in quarter 4 it is loss, in quarter 1 it is only 13,411 profit, and in quarter 2 1,31,333. So obviously maximum profit is in quarter 3, so it is correct, right? So now let's see another is count. So we can write here, okay, so we can write total number of I insert one cell, okay, enter row in the, okay, sorry, okay, so let's say one enter, so total, say total items. So we have to find total items. All right so total items, that means here we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all right but again I am saying if there are thousands of items, so 500 of items, you cannot count like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So for that there is a formula, that is count, C O U N T, count, alright. Then you can select this. So count, sorry, the formula always starts is equal count. So now select the first cell. Now see, those cells we are selecting in this are continuous, isn't it? Means continue from top to bottom. So we can either write before comma, then this comma, this, then this, then this, right? So we can either write such this way, sorry, okay, we cannot write this way, sorry, we can simply write like this, selected from here to here, alright. Okay, some problem to show you. Okay, so yeah, so numbers should be there, alright. Then we can count. So 5 items are there, alright. Now so this is the thing that we are discussing. So we have seen count, we have seen average, we have seen maximum, similarly we can find minimum, then we have seen the if, another way of writing if when you have multiple options, right? So now some things, some formatting things you can do. See, you can give the format of different cells or colors of different cells differently. So for that, let's select this. Okay, so let's say for loss, will my background cell will be red. Okay, says this way it will be, and for profit say it will be say green. So for example, like this it will be, right? So for say there are some multiple cells, so if you are keep doing one by one, it will be very difficult, right? So let's see how we can do directly. So for that we have to select the whole data, then we will go conditional formatting, right? So in few excels you will see in home only conditional formatting is there, in few excels there will be another head name format. Okay, so you go to conditional formatting, go highlight cells rules. Okay, now based on what, whether you will highlight based on greater than, less than, between, equal to, or text. So it is based on text, so we'll select this. So when it is when the text is profit, okay, what color will give, say green, the green. So we can select here also border field, we can select say green will use, alright. Okay, again for loss, when it is loss, you can go custom format, fix red. Okay, let's see. Alright, so sorry, so you have to be careful. So you have to be careful while doing it. Alright, so again let's do, I forgot to click the OK button. Okay, so see profit to happen. Now let's again select they will do it for loss. Okay. In loss, fill it with red. Alright, okay. Don't forget to click this. Okay, alright. See, profit became green, loss became red. So if there are thousands of data also at once, we can do that. Similarly, you can do this also. Go to conditional formatting, highlight cell, text date contents. Contents, contents, profit, it will go as green. Okay, and text it contents loss, it will background becomes red. Alright, okay, so again same mistake, I forgot to click OK at the beginning. Profit custom green. Okay, got it. For amount also, say if you want to show, select, then conditional formatting. So here you can do by greater than, right? So if it is greater than how much, say if it is greater than zero, then it is profit, right? If it is greater than zero, then it is profit. Okay, and if it is less than zero, then it is loss, right? So similarly for others also you can do, or you can try profit and loss. Alright, so let's do the for this also conditional statement. Highlight, if greater than 0, then I have to print what, green. Okay, and if it is again conditional statement, go, if it is less than 0, I have to print what, custom format red, that is it will show loss. Alright, done. Similarly for others also you can do. Then there are borders we have not given, right? So we can enter borders. Okay, so borders. Okay, sec, borders we have not given. We'll enter borders here. Go here and all borders, right? So you can see it is there. Okay, any doubts you can query me. Thank you.